Hi everyone and welcome back. So this is another problem of Node.js intermediate certification, and this is really an important problem and of a different type. Okay, here we have to write an authorization middleware. So first we will talk about the readme file, like what is the problem statement and then how we are going to solve it. Okay, so complete the middleware.js module. This is what we need to do it. The module's default export is an Express.js middleware. Express.js middleware is a simple function which takes a request, response, and next function. This function should parse X role header. That will give us the role value. The scope of the route is passed in the middleware, like scope name and action name. For example, to check user has access to a particular task, this middleware has to decide that the user has access to this particular route or particular task or not. Okay, so in the this is how the role scope objects looks like. Okay, and this is inside rules.txt. Okay, yes, this is actually a text file which is of JSON like. Okay, this is the text file, and what it says is, okay, admin role will have a scope of create and get by ID tasks. Okay, this is the scope of the admin. So the role of the property. So from this header X role, we will get the role of the user. Then you will check in this file if the role is equal to the role which is in the roles.txt, then only we should be allowing user to access these tasks. If role is admin, then we will check, okay, the task is create or get by ID or not. Okay, this property which has to match with the X role header, right? An object containing the key value pair corresponding to the scope name of the system. The passed scope name doesn't match with any of the key. That means user doesn't have access to send 403. The scope name is a dynamic key. You can see the task has this array. Okay, now what we can do is, this is the middleware.js. What we are doing here, it's simply a simple code. I didn't try to make it complex. What we are doing is, we are checking if role is there. Okay, if role is not there, then explicitly send 403, because these routes are protected. So role must be there in the headers. If role is there, then we have to start reading the roles.txt file. Okay, if we see any error while reading the file, that means 403. If we got the role, here we also getting the scope. Okay, we are passing the scope in the middleware that contains the method name and action. Okay, and here we get the content of the text file, which is a mapper. Now here the only logic is line 30. We need to check this particular role which is specified in the X role is allowed for this scope or not based on this text file. Okay, so we have this kind of a content in the file. This is the content of the text file. We are writing a middleware function where we are going to pass the scope. Now we have the role from the request header. We will check that this admin role is allowed for this scope or not. So that is being done on the line 30. Check role. Here we are getting the scope. This is the mapper, means JSON object. Local scope, action, and role, all three things we have. We have whatever the content from the text file, what is the current role of the logged in user, what is the action and scope that user is looking for. Okay, so how we are going to use it? So I will check some particular route. There we might be using this middleware, and we are passing the scope and both the things. So this is the scope, this is the action, this is the scope, this is the action. And how we can pass a middleware, like express.router.get, router path name, middleware, and then handler. This is the syntax. So we put the middleware here. We are passing a string. This is a scope and this is the action. Now if we go to the middleware, the same middleware which we are writing. So we got the scope name. So from the scope, we split this string using dot, and we got the scope name and action. Scope name is if we just go to the routes, scope name is tasks, and action is get by ID and create. Now we got everything. We got the JSON parsed, the processed JSON, which is a JSON object from the file. we got the role of currently logged in user, we got the scope name, we got the action, everything is there. This is the only code we have to write. We are iterating onto this array object mapper and we are checking the role. If role is same as the role which is passed in the request, then only we should allow, otherwise we will return false. If the role is matching, we will get the scope from the file JSON object, and then we are just checking if the scope is matching. If the scope which user is asking, like tasks.create task.getByID, is available in the scope of the file, that means we want to allow, and we are doing nothing, we are just checking inside a scope, yes, tasks is there. So if you already know, like this is a JSON object, I will just open the readme file and we will get the sample JSON file from there. So sample JSON file contains the role and the scope attribute. This is a sample JSON file. Let's copy and paste it so we can see things closely. Okay, here we are checking first role, then we are checking the scope. Okay, scope of task, local scope is a task and action name is create or get by ID. So we are checking in the scope, task is a property or not. If yes, that means now task is an array. So here scope of local scope means the get by ID and create, if it is there, local scope is there, that means user is allowed to perform this particular action. That's it. And when you run all the test cases, everything will pass. So there may be a multiple or different set of problems you may see on HackerRank, which is doing nothing but they will ask you to write a middleware. Middleware will take some inputs like the role or any kind of argument, and you will be given a file, you read the file, you process the file, and you get all the role, all the actions which are allowed in that particular file, and then you check what is being passed from the router to call the middleware. We are passing like scope is tasks and action is create. Yes, for admin, if the role we are passing in the header is admin, then he is allowed. Now you can also check the tests, what kind of tests we are executing. So you can see we are passing role customer, so it will be 403. We are passing invalid role, it will be 403. Okay, here we are passing, let's say, the bottom test cases. Here we are passing admin. So this is a task and task by ID, it should be allowed. Task create, it should be allowed, right? So here also we are doing the same set of things, and for all of these, because role is not specified, so it will be a 403. So all these test cases will give you a validation. Okay, your test case, your code is correct. Whatever you have written in the middleware.js, you are reading a file. So we are using fs module, fs.read file. We have roles file there already in the text file. We are reading it, and we are, because this is a text file, we have to parse it back. And sometimes you will see parse errors. So this is additional check I have added, like while reading the UTF encoding of the file, I'm just removing some special characters and then doing the parse. And then I finally got the object. I'm passing that in a check role. This is really very important problems. I have seen these kind of problems in multiple places, like write a middleware, read rules from a particular file. A lot of Node.js problem statements revolves around the FS module and writing these middlewares and the complex things. Okay, thanks everyone.